Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Yasmin. If you're not, then subscribe. I decided to step out of my box for the first time in a long time and create this like cut crease. You can see, I'm not winking at you, it's just a cut crease. Yeah, this is new for me. I don't know, this is all affordable products on the eyes and like highlight. The face has got obviously Fenty because that's all I wear, but yeah, the eyes are definitely affordable. I chose to use really like thin kind of sparse eyelashes because I didn't want it to take away from the cut crease look. So yeah, if you're interested in how I got this look, please continue watching. Like, subscribe, comment, share, tell me what else you'd want me to film. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Oh, by the way, I am wearing a shirt. It just looks like I'm naked. I'm wearing a shirt, guys. But yeah, I will see you guys in the next one. Bye. To start off this look, I'm just using some basic brushes and using my Revolution Neutrals 2 palette, which is like a dupe for the Renaissance palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills. I'm going in with a fluffy brush, and this is the Fluffy Brush 42 from NARS. I'm just blending that into my eye shadow, my eyes, just focusing on the crease. And yeah, I'm just going to keep building this color up on my eyes because this is obviously going to be a cut crease. So yeah, I need a lot of color on my eyes. Then I'm taking a Morphe brush. I can't remember what this brush was or what it's called. It doesn't say. But it's a more dense fluffy brush and I'm using the same shade, but as you can see it looks deeper in tone because of the dense fluffy brush. And I'm just focusing this color more into the crease, not really taking it up high. And if I need to do a bit more blending, I'm just going to go back in with the same brush before, no new product on it, just blend out what you've done already. And I'm taking these two shades. I know it doesn't look that different on the palette, but on the eyes it kind of does look a bit different. But yeah, just blending, blending, blending. Then I'm taking a Kiko Milano eyeshadow. I can't remember what it's called. I remember to put it in the description. And I'm taking a Morphe M139 brush, which is like perfect for cut creases. And I'm just packing that color into my crease. Yeah, just keep going back and forth. And then blending it out with the Morphe brush that I used before. Then taking my Carolan concealer palette, using some really light shade, and I'm gonna cut the crease with a MAC 135 brush. It's basically the concealer brush. I'm just cutting that crease. I think I always have to do a weird face when I'm doing like cut creases and things like that. Then I'm just packing on some translucent powder with the Bobbi Brown angled eyeshadow brush. And the reason why I'm using translucent powder, because this concealer is quite creamy and if I don't set it well, it will crease. Then I'm going in with that top shade and using the angled brush, and not the angled brush, the crease brush, and I'm just packing it onto the side of my eyes. Then using this dusty pink shade and packing it on. Honestly, this palette is so good. It's so, so pigmented. Oh my god. It's actually quite creamy as well. And then I've also put that shade on my eyes as well. I just did it like before, you just didn't see. Then using that light white shade, I'm just putting that on my crease to give more of an effect. And then I'm just gonna use that same brush to blend it in to the pink, so it's more like a gradient. So just keep doing that until it blends out. Looking cute. I'm just dusting a bit of whatever was left on the brush and just go back in. Like I didn't add any more color. I just dusted what's left off the brush and put it on my eyes. Yeah, now I'm using NYX white liner. Now this is like new for me. This is so out of my comfort zone and I found this very difficult. The problem with this white eyeliner is I feel like the brush is too flimsy. It needs to be a bit more hard or thick so that it like you can get into the crease more. But I'm just cleaning up with a bit of the Kiko Milano shadow and an angled brush just to clean up a bit more. Then I'm packing more of that darker pink shade on my eyes
and then blended it in with the angled eyeshadow brush. But yeah, sorry if one eye is wonky than the other, like, this is my first time doing like a serious cut crease, so give me props, guys. Yeah, I'm just using a Maybelline eyeliner. I like this eyeliner because it's dark, but it transfers, like, if you rub your eye, it's like, it's on there. Then I'm taking a NARS 44 brush, and yeah, just packing the same colours that I used, the first colours that I used under my eyes, and then going with that tangerine shade, putting it under, just mixing it about, guys, really, don't really mind me. And then using that crease brush again, and whatever was left on it, just to blend in the eyeshadow, so it's more like a pink now. Then taking a spectrum brush, these are not numbered, so I have no idea, but it's a flat angled brush, not angled, it's a flat brush. And then taking some Maybelline L'Oreal, I don't know, mascara. I don't really like this mascara, so I don't really talk about it, to be honest. I think it's pretty much useless. But yeah, just to add a bit of like colour to my eyes, onto my eyelashes. Gonna finish my face. There we go, looking spiffy. Got my lashes on. I used some Ardell with Demi Wispies, and this is me trying to wink. Oh my god! Taking my Cleopatra Kiss, my favorite highlight palette of all. Did you see that smirk? I love that highlighter palette. And yeah, just highlighting my face. Don't be afraid. I've been loving this person on Instagram called Namro. Oh my god, I'm gonna write the name there. She is amazing. Oh, she's just like dewy all the time. It just looks perfect. I have oily skin, I've realized, like really oily. So yeah, but oh my god, it's just so beautiful, her Instagram. Then taking this little brush from Spectrum Brushes and doing the brow highlight. I've been, honestly, she's been inspiring me so much. So much. Oh, by the way, I'm only wearing one pump of Fenty foundation on my face. Can we do that one pump? Yes, it's amazing. Just thought I'd let you guys know. Yeah, just going in with the two highlight shades. Then doing my nose, just the bridge, not the tip. And then whatever was left, I just put on my inner corner. Then doing my Cupid's bow. I should really do an updated foundation. And a concealer tutorial for you guys, because I've changed it up a bit. So I thought I'd try colour. This is Colourpop, I can't remember what it's called, but it's a cute colour. And I was like, should I go for colourful lips? So yeah. Then this is a Milani colour. I'll put it there, down there below. I think it's called Loved. Yeah, I don't know what you guys think. Like, the colours doesn't look too bad with the look, but it just wasn't feeling it, to be honest. I just wasn't feeling it. It looks cute, but it just took away from the eyes, I think. So I tried to like mute it down with some of the Fenty Matchstick in Suede. But yeah, I just didn't like it, so I took it off. Yeah, so I'm just muting up my lips again with Suede from Fenty. And then taking what I had on before, which is the Too Faced Lip Injections in Milkshake, I think this one's called. I can't remember. And there you have it. Put some highlight on. Boom. And there you have it, guys. I hope you really liked this tutorial, and I hope you subscribe, like, comment, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!